Anyway.
Men, if you say you're a feminist, then fuck like a feminist. And if you don't want to do that, take off your fucking pin, because we are not your accessories.
So the left is outraged about the backlash to the Me Too movement, simply because people are drawing a distinction between making sexual advances and actual sexual assault. So Aziz Ansari goes on a date with a woman. They go back to his apartment. She voluntarily gives him a blowjob, then messages him the next day saying he ignored her non-verbal cues that she wasn't interested. Yeah, you were sending a pretty big non-verbal cue when you put his dick in your mouth. Ansari apologized and said he misread the situation. Is that sexual harassment? No. But now his career is forever tainted. Of course there's going to be a backlash to the Me Too movement. If women just start using it as a weapon to exact revenge and to advance their own victimhood status and careers.
Here's an unpopular opinion. I'm actually not at all concerned about innocent men losing their jobs over false sexual assault harassment allegations.
Of course there's going to be a backlash to the Me Too movement when you're obviously using it as a partisan tool to claim political scalps. By claiming someone asking for your phone number is sexual assault.
Is it true he asked for your phone number?
Yeah.
Newsflash, it isn't. Of course there's going to be a backlash to the Me Too movement. If it's being led by rapist paedophile apologists like Meryl Streep and Harvey Weinstein's best buddy, Oprah Winfrey. Exactly as I predicted months ago, the Me Too movement has been rolled into the left's wider war on men and masculinity. Nearly 25% of US millennial men think that asking a woman out for a drink is sexual harassment. 25%. If you really think that, then start saving up for a sex robot, because it's going to be a long, lonely life.
Sex is one of the most fascinating things in the world.
Men are saturated day in, day out with the idea that we should be ashamed of being men, that our very masculinity is toxic.
Toxic masculinity is killing everyone. Repeat. Toxic masculinity is killing everyone. Repeat. Toxic masculinity is killing everyone. Repeat. We could go on.
But when you ask women, even women in California, whether they prefer typically masculine or effeminate men, there's no contest.
This is number one.
Okay.
This is number two. Which one do you prefer?
Number two.
Okay, one more time. This is number one.
Okay.
This is number two. Which one do you prefer?
Number two.
This is number one.
Okay.
This is number two. Which one do you prefer?
Number two.
This is number one. Number two.
Number two.
You can't shame men for being men, denigrate their natural impulse to chase women, conflate that with rape and sexual assault, then complain, where have all the real men gone? I mean, look at the damage that's already been done. A whole generation of skinny jeans wearers. What man in their right mind would naturally want to wear skinny jeans? Skinny jeans reduce sperm count. Your balls need room to breathe to properly produce sperm. That's why they dangle. They need to be away from the body to maintain a cooler temperature for ideal sperm production. Skinny jeans also cause urinary tract infections because the pressure leads to an overactive bladder. They also cause twisted testicles. Where's the upside? Why are you wearing them anyway? Because they're trendy. You're literally crushing your own balls to look like a soy boy. You look stupid. It's not worth it. Stop it. But forget skinny jeans. Fashion designers are now pushing female clothing as the next men's fashion trend. For their recent catwalk show, Undercover had these skeletal soy boys parading around in maxi skirts. This fashion designer is portraying men as pigs and dogs. We're also bombarded with advertising lecturing us about how awful it is to be a man.
Manspreading and mansplaining need to stop.
Translation: how dare you have a penis and balls that require you to spread your legs to be comfortable when sitting down. Oh, and because of your gender and nothing else, you also need to shut the fuck up.
Hashtag be better.
They're now even equating manspreading with the Me Too movement and sexual assault. How many TV ads have you seen where the man is portrayed as a useless idiot?
It's just a burst pipe. I can fix it.
My husband is,
You missed a spot.
I got that job at the demolition company.
It smells bad.
We don't have steak often, so when I got home from Walmart, I could tell what my husband was thinking. Steak. Is it her birthday? Our anniversary? Is it my birthday?
Seal. Shake. And let Oven Pride do its thing, so he can do more. Oven Pride. So easy, a man can do it.
Okay, maybe it was my fault.
She told me to kill the weeds.
And you did, along with the grass.
I used the wrong stuff.
Oh, there were dead spots everywhere.
Dad's making dinner.
Oh, it'll be fine. Maybe.
But it's not wasteful, because it won't go off again for another 30 minutes. Unless, of course, you press the boost button.
And I can hear it now from all the feminists. Hashtag masculinity so fragile. What a snowflake you are. Say the same snowflakes who lobbied for cooking and cleaning commercials featuring only women to be banned. We're also now being subjected to the humor holocaust that is woke comedy.
A 28-year-old man expects praise for not being a misogynist.
I mean, we can't even enjoy historical war movies without feminists whining about how they're part of the grand patriarchal conspiracy. The New York Times can tweet, if you let boys be boys, they will murder their fathers and sleep with their mothers. Nobody really gives a damn, but Lewis Hamilton says boys don't wear princess dresses.
Why did you ask for a princess dress for Christmas? Boys don't wear princess dresses!
And everyone loses their minds. He's witch-hunted and forced to grovel and apologize. What in God's name is happening? At the lower levels, this is just do-good virtue signaling and outright man-hating by ugly feminists who can't get boyfriends. But beyond that, there's something more sinister taking place. A giant re-education campaign aimed at turning boys and young men into total pussies. Not only are we under chemical assault from plastic products and foods that lower testosterone, we're mass unwitting participants in a huge social engineering experiment based around vilifying masculinity and demoralizing men. And the Me Too movement has been co-opted to serve that agenda. What kind of warped scheme needs to dilute or destroy masculinity and traditional gender roles to succeed? One that seeks to completely annihilate the fundamental structure of Western society, so the annihilators can completely remake it in their own image. This is about the pursuit of raw power. This is Marxism rebranded. Identity politics, the very ideology that belittles and denigrates men, particularly white men, is just a new form of an old Marxist trick. Divide and conquer. They think that by dragging down men, by neutering masculine competitive and risk-taking traits, they can create equality of outcome. They can create utopia. These postmodernists are so pathological, so deranged. They've convinced themselves that fundamental biological science is a grand conspiracy invented by the patriarchy.
'Cause my sex junk is so, much more than either.
And now they're going to convince everyone else, by law, by force, by silencing dissent, and by mass indoctrination. They're literally rebelling against reality. They've declared war on logic. Gender and gender roles are not, and never can be, a social construct. Masculinity is not a narrative that can be changed with enough brainwashing. It's an objective truth. You can't reverse hundreds of millions of years of evolutionary biology. Gender role stereotypes exist for a reason. They're how humanity survived and prospered.
Men and women won't sort themselves into the same categories if you leave them alone to do it of their own accord. I've already seen that in Scandinavia. It's 20 to 1. Female nurses to male, something like that. It might not be quite that extreme. And approximately the same male engineers to female engineers. And that's a consequence of the free choice of men and women in the societies that have gone farther than any other societies to make gender equality the purpose of the law. Those are ineradicable differences. You can eradicate them with tremendous social pressure and tyranny. But if you leave men and women to make their own choices, you will not get equal outcomes.
Men and women excel at different things. This is determined by hardwired biological differences and divergent character traits. You can't change that by giving your baby boy a Barbie doll and sticking him in a dress. You're not changing these boys and men into better people. You're making them depressed, broken, and lonely. Stop it. All you're going to achieve is a generation of messed up, unhappy young men. Men already have suicide rates 5 times higher than women. Is that not enough for you people? We need to reject the collectivist tyranny that because some men do evil things, all men need to bear the burden of evil. No, I'm an individual, as is the next man. I'm only responsible for my own actions. We need to create better role models for young men than vapid celebrities. We need to confidently reassert the true value and meaning of masculinity. Not one based around lad culture, boorishness, or any facsimile of masculinity, but one based around competency, responsibility, audacity, bravado, and just having the temerity to stand up and say no. I'm not ashamed to be a man. Please click the big red button to subscribe. It really helps me when you do that. And click the bell to allow notifications so you never miss a new video.